Yeah, so I met one mechanic yesterday. So he was showing me one particular Peugeot car that the owner wants to sell. I think the vehicle, I don't know, probably the person brought it to his workshop for repairs, and I think they are even doing body work on the car. The owner now wants to sell the vehicle. But he was not telling me story behind why the owner wants to sell the car. That is a Peugeot 406 with the EW10J4 engine. The owner, I think, while they were working on the car, doing body work, so I think he started using it, another brand of car. He said it's a Toyota, what's the name, Yaris. No, that small Yaris, small car. So from there, I think, according to him, he was driving it as if he was driving his Peugeot 406, which he is already used to. And then all of a sudden he found himself in an accident. The car, I think he tried to swerve it as if he was swerving his Peugeot 406, and the car somersaulted, and I don't know, he said he's even broke his arm or something. So it's either he's still in the hospital, or you know, he now decided that he can't use the car anymore. Maybe he may not even be able to drive. I don't know. I really don't get the whole thing. So but my point on doing this video is, you know, guys, what can you compare? You see, that's the mistake people make. They look down on Peugeot cars, even when they use them or own those cars. They think, oh, it's just a non-performer. Yet when you not drive one of the some of the things you do on Peugeot cars and some other brands, you see yourself inside the bush. How can you think that Peugeot 406 you can drive a small car, that car that looks like paper, tissue paper? I don't even know how to. Yeah, tissue paper. Tissue paper even have some weight, like all these small A4 size paper, or just a piece of paper. It's too light. It's not meant for that kind of handling. Moses is a road handler. It may not be the best when it comes to road handling, but how can you compare the way you drive your 406? You start doing the same thing. That's what the tire is. And because of that, you almost lost your life. So guys, be very careful. Huh? Very careful. I don't understand people the way. I'm not saying I'm blaming the guy, but I'm saying for other people. Just because your Peugeot car is doing, you can do so many things with it and nothing happens, means other brand of car will handle that kind of thing. Peugeot cars, basically, even the smallest one, even Peugeot 206, go and drive a Peugeot 206, you understand. As small as they are, yet they handle very, very well on high speed. I'm not saying all of them are meant for performance. There are some that the suspension are just basic. You know, like all those ones with TU3, JP engine. Yeah, they might not handle the way the ones with EW10J4 or EW10J4S would, because their suspensions, I don't think they are the same. And you look at the setup of the vehicle, you know, the ground cars, it can't be the same. You know, so, you know, still they will handle, but then because stop comparing Peugeot with all the Japanese cars, guys. They may not have the biggest or the most powerful engines, but they are load handlers, as small as they are. You know, so if you drive them, like, see if you look down on them, because that's what most people do. They will look down on Peugeot cars and say, oh, is this a this thing? They only consider German vehicles as the only car that can handle road very well. You know, when you drive them on road and push them hard, that's the only one that can give you the best performance. So in that case, they will see Peugeot. They will see Peugeot cars and Japanese cars are the same. Well, you've not seen it, unless maybe the mechanic doesn't know the full story. But from what he gathered, maybe it was the owner, that the person himself, that told him that he tried to, because that's what he said, he tried to drive it or swerve it like usually do on his 406, and the car somersaulted and his hand broke. And of course, you may have some other injuries on the body, but that's the major one that made him decide to sell his 406. So, I don't know. So that's my advice, guys. Appreciate your Peugeot for what it is. And when you drive other vehicles, be very careful. Try to understand that car first. Even just to test drive it, try to understand it. Drive it slowly. Understand it. Check the limit of that car, what it can handle. Don't drive immediately because start pushing it like you drive your Peugeot cars. You may end up where you don't expect or you never wish to be. That's what I'm saying. So please, please, there is no way Peugeot 406 and Toyota Yaris will be the same in terms of road handling. That's why I'm saying this video. For those of you who will still go tomorrow, even the Toyota Corolla itself, those ones produced the same year of Peugeot 406. Please don't even compare them. You may think I'm here to talk down on Toyota products. No, it's your life we are talking about. Don't even talk about it. If you want, you can go to forums or start comparing and start making noise that I don't know what I'm talking about, that Toyota cars are better than Peugeot cars. It's none of my business. But somebody now is in the hospital. He almost lost or killed himself because he thought the Toyota cars can handle as good as Peugeot cars. An old 406 could handle the way he wanted, yet the Toyota Yaris could not. Something even 206 can handle, but the Toyota Yaris could not handle it. Well, maybe there's something here, maybe he drove it differently, that he drives his 406 and whatever happened. But the fact is, they are not the same. They are not in the same league. In terms of road handling, I don't care about power. In terms of road handling, please, 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 be very careful. Master the vehicle. Check. Drive it. Test it a little to see if you handle small kinds of push around. If it doesn't, drive it slowly till you get rid of the vehicle.